Ever heard of polycystic ovary syndrome? You might have heard of it if you're a woman who has had trouble getting pregnant or experienced very painful or irregular periods. PCOS is one of the most common causes of female infertility. The three main characteristics of PCOS are high androgen levels, polycystic ovaries, and irregular periods. While the exact cause of PCOS is unknown, we do know that women with PCOS have high levels of the pituitary hormone known as the luteinizing hormone. If you have never heard of this hormone before, I recommend watching my video on the normal menstrual cycle first, as it will help you understand the physiology of PCOS better. Elevated levels of LH cause the ovaries to produce an excessive amount of testosterone. Despite testosterone being commonly referred to as the male hormone, both males and females produce it. High testosterone levels are responsible for the many physical symptoms of PCOS, such as facial and body hair growth, acne, and hair loss. The combination of high levels of LH and testosterone impacts the ovary's ability to develop eggs properly. Under normal circumstances, the pituitary gland in the brain produces both LH and follicle-stimulating hormones and sends them to the ovaries. A surge of LH occurs in the middle of the cycle, signaling the ovaries to ovulate. However, as the levels of LH are already elevated in individuals with PCOS, the LH surge does not occur. Without an LH surge, there's no ovulation, and this explains the frequent, irregular, or missed periods and the fertility issues. At the same time, the pituitary gland releases lower than normal levels of FSH, which prevents eggs from reaching full maturity. These immature eggs accumulate in the ovaries, form cysts, and appear as dark circles on ultrasound scans. Many women live with PCOS for years without realizing it. In fact, PCOS is often diagnosed only after a woman experiences infertility, the most significant symptom of the condition. The mainstay treatment of PCOS is to use Clomid, an ovulation induction medicine. Common side effects include mood swings, hot flashes, and breast tenderness. Clomid has a similar structure to estrogen and blocks estrogen receptors throughout the reproductive system. This tricks the brain into believing that the levels of circulating estrogen are low, which causes the brain to release more FSH. The increased levels of FSH lead to the development of an egg that secretes more estrogen into the bloodstream. Clomid is taken for 5 days. After about a week, the receptors are no longer blocked, and this triggers an LH surge in response to the artificially elevated levels of estrogen. When it comes to stimulating ovulation, Clomid is very successful. Up to 85% of women who use Clomid will ovulate. However, only about 10 to 13% of those same women will fall pregnant per cycle. Thus, Clomid is not an infertility cure-all. Please watch my next video to learn more about labor and delivery.